I got a 100 guns and 100 clips. Nigga, I'm from New York. I got a semi-automatic that spits next time if you talk. I got a 100 guns and 100 clips. Nigga, I'm from New York. I got a semi-automatic that spits next time if you talk. And I know y'all niggas is pussy, panani, vagina. Your monologues getting tired. Now it's time to ride. Apprentice, you're fired. You're no longer desired. So take off them silly chains. Put back on your wire. I'm on fire. Holly dipped in octane. Let East Coast bang. Let West Coast bang. And Rule gon' bring the ghetto gospel to every hood possible. Pushing through in the sky blue. Back with the guard you now. Preferably the 4 pound. Slugs flying at the speed of sound. Trying to catch the ears of niggas that's running.
I'm just a component of intelligence, living in an environment to distribute loyalty in the form of intellect itself. I've always been that way. Ever since a child, I've known many things on an unconscious level. But my mother taught me that just because you have no knowledge of things at the time, doesn't mean that it isn't asleep inside of your DNA. You see, because you are your DNA. And this is where all of the memory and thoughts that you have ever had in the many lives that you have endured. Your DNA is where all of this is stored. And in the midst of what we call life, one must remember that everything is alike, just in a different form and frequency. For an example, 100 is one, because it is one that has created fragments of itself to become that 100. No different from you being in your environment or being your environment. You are a part of everything in your environment, even the thoughts and the minds of those bodies that is in your company. Now, what do I mean by this? What I am saying is that when you study a thought, the foundation of a thought is energy, and we are all energy resonating with the energy of each other, therefore causing us to be everywhere, even though we have no consciousness of the places we are or that we exist in, the many forms that we are still there. Everything comes from a thought, which is darkness. Then light appeared, which is the illusion of the real light, which is darkness itself. Even in the Bible, it says that light come out of darkness, meaning that the darkness is the creator of the light. Follow me, family. Just think with me. What I am showing you is the elements of our ancestors, which is a mystery to most, even a mystery to the Africans that dwell within the so-called conscious community. These are Africans without a soul. These are just bodies. These are just vehicles that have sold themselves out for a piece of material that is worthless to the spiritual mind. The world is not bigger than your mind, because it is your mind that projects the world through your eyes by way of how you are seeing the world. The world is nothing without the mind, because it is the mind that creates the images that the world is in. Everything that happens here on this third dimension is a cause being projected from where you really exist, which is in the subconscious part of your mind. I want you to open your mind and walk with me for an eon or for a second. Those who are autistic have a higher intelligence in another realm or another dimension. Look around at this world and what this world calls intelligence. It is nothing. If you don't believe me, just look at what this world is curing. It is curing nothing. What you perceive as normal here is actually a handicap in another dimension. This is determined by the natural laws, which is the true master degree or PhD. I'm going to address something else about autistic children. These beings, or these precious children, are so intelligent that not only can they hear notes from instruments, but they can see these notes, rearrange the frequencies of these notes, and heal the people in their environment with these notes. This is true. A lot of people assume that the vaccines is the cause of this intelligence, when in all actuality, they have already tapped into it before the baby became a child, and they shoot them with these vaccines to try to turn off some of the intelligence within their DNA before they become the age of 6 and 7 years old. We have consciousness all around us. It's just that it has been labeled as special needs and satanic. When I said that your thoughts and dreams could be stolen and infiltrated through our DNA, I was also called crazy. But it seems that when a European say the things that a non-European say, he is correct. So I'm going to give reference from that which makes you conscious slaves more comfortable. I'll give you your reference from your European slave master, you Africans without souls. The same Africans who would like to use terminology pseudo, but the same information that they are utilizing comes from their slave master. Now, from an article by a man named Hassam, H-A-S-S-A-M, who is referencing scientists that has experimented with remote technology or remote neuromonitoring, it states, this technology is called remote neuromonitoring, RNM, and it is expected to revolutionize crime detection and investigation. RNM works remotely to control the brain in order to read and detect any criminal thought taking place inside of the mind of a possible perpetrator. Research studies have shown that the human brain thinks at a rate of about 5,000 bits per second and does not have the capacity to compete with supercomputers performing via satellites, implants, and biotelemetry. The human brain has a distinctive set of bioelectric resonance systems. For the RNM system, supercomputers are being used, and thus, with its help, supercomputers can send messages through an implanted person's nervous system in order to influence their performance in a desired way. RNM has been developed after about 50 years of neuroelectromagnetic involuntary human experimentations. According to many scientists, within a few years, it is expected that DNA microchips would be implanted in the human brain, which would make it inherently controllable. With RNM, it would be possible to read and control a person's emotional thought process along with the subconscious and even their dreams. At present, around the world, supercomputers are monitoring millions of people simultaneously with the speed of 20 billion bits per second, especially in countries like the United States, Japan, Israel, and many European countries. RNM has a set of certain programs functioning at different levels, like the signals intelligence system, which uses electromagnetic frequencies, EMF, to stimulate the brain for RNM and the electronic brain link. But they don't have to instill chips in your brain to set off vibrations and frequencies to turn these images into voices. Your brain already has a system of frequencies. It's called brainwave frequency that simultaneously is in rhythm with the universe's vibrations, so they can use satellites to take your voice and download the frequencies into these satellites. Reprogram them, restructure these voices and vibrations and send them back to your brain in the form of your wife or the form of your children or the form of your doctor. For those in the military, this is what they are putting in your food. This is what they are putting in your water. They are inserting these compounds or these components with these vibrations that has been reshaped and restructured. And what they do is they put them into your body in the form of mercury chips. And it sets in your body and you cannot digest it unless you get chlorella, unless you use chlorophyll. And I'm talking about chlorophyll A, not chlorophyll B, but chlorophyll A and chlorella will take these satellites and these chips out of your body. They are undetectable. They are small as a grain of sand on the beach. But these people are literally going into our minds. And by way of our dreams, all dreams are initiated within the subconscious, which is the seventh gate, or it's the seventh chakra. And this is where your information from your ancestors, which is the four moons or the suns, is being telecommunicated to you by way of photosynthesis. And they are trying to reject it through your body. They're trying to become your mind so that they can reject it through your mind. It's sort of like suicide. So it's time for us to wake up. It's time for us to graduate into higher forms of consciousness. It's okay to call the black woman God. That's fine. She know that she's more than a God, because the word God, again, is only 600 years old. She's older than 600 years old. She's older than numbers itself. She's older than the constellations. The woman's energy is being birthed. She has been implemented into the systems of the mothers of the councils. Within the constellations of Orion, she was before Sirius A and Sirius B. She was before any star system, meaning she was before any God. It's time to restructure our thoughts. It's time to use our mind and know that this is a spiritual battle going on. They want you to see it as a physical, because they are physical beings meaning they only have a brain. They don't have a mind. The mind is the soul. You are the mind. That is your body. You can go to the fifth dimension. When you study the fingerprints on Europeans' fingers, there are only three prints that is implemented on their hands. All five of our prints is implemented. It is activated. This is why we're going to the fifth dimension. Five fingers. They can only stay within the third dimension. All right. This is Osaka 4. And I'm out, family. One love.